This is the city that is set upon the hill that cannot be hidden event. We are the Rolls Royce of all entertainment shows and television events that show with a difference. If your celebration is not an event, we wonder where else it will be. On our very first show today.
Events, we have to.
That's why I had to come over and introduce myself to you. Cause you're never gonna know where you find love. And hopefully I'll find it in you. Yeah. Can I take you out tonight? Got love for you, baby. I'll come get you, baby.
Father, we thank you because you're a gracious God. We thank you for life and we thank you for grace. We thank you for bringing us here in safety and we thank you for good health. We thank you for this event this evening and we thank you for the initiative that IA represents, the IA Foundation.
Oh, can I just say something first? You're all looking $1 million. You're looking gorgeous. You're looking beautiful. Looking handsome. Thanks for making the effort. And thanks for being here. If I may, I would like to stand on the existing protocol because of time. However, it's important that I thank God for this initiative. Because the whole idea came as a flash when I was just praying one day in the morning and this idea came. The following month, I went to Nigeria and I was driving on the Third Mainland Bridge and I saw a boy. He was about 7 years old. This was about 10 o'clock at night, trying to clean my windscreen. A 7-year-old boy. I'm a mother. I'm a grandmother, I have a 10-year-old son as well, and I imagined my son being on Third Mainland Bridge at 10 o'clock at night, trying to clean somebody's windshield. It broke my heart. I was close to tears, and I said I need to do something about this. This cannot continue. This is not right. It's not fair either. And considering I work in the education sector in the UK, I thought it would be a good idea to start up this foundation. Because as you all know, we've got security challenges in Nigeria. So because of that, especially in the northern part of Nigeria, most parents are not sending their kids to school. In December 2018, United Nations had a survey and the number of students out of school, children out of school, was 13.2 million out of a population of about 200 million. The previous year, it was 10.4. Now, this statistics was taken in December 2018. We are now in January 2020. I can bet you that figure has increased. These are our future. We can't afford to look away. And for our country, to have children, the future leaders of our country, to be uneducated. So somebody needs to do something about this. And it seems the government of the day is so preoccupied with the security challenges in Nigeria, they've got no time to even think about these kids that are out of school, not knowing that this is a vicious circle, that these kids that you ignore now will become the Boko Haram of the future. So because the government has taken its eye off the ball, somebody needs to address that. Somebody needs to raise the awareness about that. That these kids need to come off the street and they need to go into the classroom. That is where they belong. 13.2 is unacceptable. It's not right. It's not fair, ladies and gentlemen. So that's where this initiative came from. And I'm so glad that you bought into the idea, because the fact that you are here today means you bought into the idea. And the fact that you'll be donating today means you bought into the idea. And we are all going to jointly take these kids off the street and make sure they go back into the classroom where they belong. However, I'm standing here today, not by my power and not by my might. I thank God for the initiative. I thank God for bringing me this far. I thank God for the success in my career. And that's the reason why I think we need to breed more people that have got good careers. I want to thank my friends, my colleagues that are all seated in here today. Thanks for your support. I cannot be here without your support. From primary to secondary to university, you've all been there for me. I want to say thank you. I want to thank my family in Christ for their prayers, for their support all the time. I'm very, very grateful. I want to thank the Board of Trustees of IA Foundation because they've really, really provided strategic leadership for this foundation. And I'd like to embarrass them today by telling them to stand up for recognition. Please, if you're a trustee of IA Foundation, please stand up for recognition, please. Papa, stand up for your husband, please. Thank you so much. Thanks for the scrutiny. Thanks for holding our feet to the fire. And thanks for providing the strategic direction we so need within the foundation. Thank you so much. Now, this event has been organized by a group of 10 men. And I use men as a generic word. And I'm sure you would agree with me that they've done so well. This committee is being led by a gentleman who I have so much admiration for, because his organization skill is out of this world. Mr. Tunde Falode, the chairman of the organizing committee. Well done. Well done. Thank you. Again, I will embarrass the members of the organizing committee by telling them to stand up for recognition, please. If you're a member of the 10 men working for the organizing committee, can you stand up for recognition, please? We need to thank you properly for your hard work. Thank you so much. I appreciate you. I adore you. I admire you. Now, I would also like to thank my family. I've got a 3-year-old grandson, and all he's been talking about for the last 3 months is IA Foundation, IA Foundation, IA Foundation. My family has been consumed by this idea of IA Foundation, and I just want to thank my family. I want to thank my children, my grandchildren, my husband, my brothers, my sisters, my niece, my nephew, and also I want to thank someone particularly. As you would appreciate, this person is very special in my life. And without this person, I wouldn't be here standing here today. This person sold her gold, her clothes, to make sure I can go to school, to make sure my fees can be paid, to make sure I can be equipped enough to stand in front of you today and to actually think about IA Foundation. Ladies and gentlemen, please give my mom a standing ovation, Mrs. Felicia Bawala. Mom, thank you so much. Thanks for everything you've done. I really appreciate you. Thanks for making me stand in front of people. Thank you. Thanks for your investment in my life. I love you. I appreciate you. I thank you. Thank you, mom. Now, thank you for doing that. IA Foundation has got 4 objectives, very simple objectives. The first is to provide bursary for children with who are going through hardship, who their parents cannot afford to put them through school. IA Foundation is saying, we will provide funding, bursary, to pay for those kids to go to school so they don't have to go on the street any longer. Second is the girl child. So, IA Foundation is looking at improving education for the girl child. IA Foundation is also trying to ensure children with learning disability, they get the extra support they require to be able to learn at the same pace as the able-bodied people. And finally, is to reward excellence in education. Those are the four objectives of IA Foundation, and that's what we are all about. Now, we cannot do this without the help of our sponsors, without the help of our donors. And I stand here today and I want to say a big thank you to everyone that has donated to IA Foundation. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. I appreciate you. I say thank you. Because without you, we can't do all we've been doing. Thank you. I pray that the Lord will reward you and the Lord will replenish you. And God will continue to provide for you. I appreciate you. I say thank you. Today is not a day of speeches. As I said, it's important for the donors and those who are willing to support us to actually have a feel of what we've been doing with their money. So what we've decided to do is to show you a clip of what we've been doing so far. So you can see that your money, your donations, what we're doing with your donations, and it's actually working.
These are the objectives of IA Foundation. Mrs. Ibirunke Adiagbo visited the university to set up an endowment fund for the best accountancy student. More so, IA Foundation visited an IDP camp in Nasarawa State. On the 30th of June 2019, IA Foundation donated to children with learning difficulties at the New Covenant Church in London. The foundation decided to use this remarkable day to visit some schools in Abeokuta, the capital of Ogun State, Nigeria. But before heading to the schools, IA Foundation paid a courtesy call to the Special Advisor of Education to the Ogun State Government, Mrs. Runke Shoyombo, in the Governor's office. The schools visited are Adeoye Lambo Memorial High School, Obada, St. Peter's College, and Nawaruddin Grammar School, Obantoko. We also took time to see the physically challenged students in these schools are promoting the awareness of our mission and vision for the Nigerian child.
To harass the situation, a non-governmental organization like wants to visit the 36 states of the country to enhance achievement of the Sustainable Development Goal on education.
13.2 million is a lot of numbers not to be going to school. And I'm thinking we need to put a dent in that number.
I can't imagine how any government can sleep well at night. This keeps me awake at night because in the UK I'm an education advocate, and when I come to Nigeria I see lots of kids on the street, and this is obviously part of the due to the insurgency and the orientation we have about a girl child's education. This is really, really very worrying, and I'm here in Nigeria now to raise the awareness that the government of the day needs to start doing something about this. We've got to reduce that number. We are the highest in the world. That is not acceptable.
Challenges are something the next level. Let every child be able to have the basic education.
We have been able to pass our message across to Nigerians on the importance of education through news reports and TV programs. And we are sure that we have made the right impact that will go a long way in making the government of the day take the issue of education more seriously.
Our hustle to contribute to the growth of our community and nation. Thank you once again, ma'am. May the Almighty God bless you and continue to put more power to the help of the foundation. Long live Fire Foundation.
So, ladies and gentlemen, I want to say thank you so much. Thanks for coming. You're looking takeaway. I wish I could take you all home tonight. Thank you. Thank you.
Oh my goodness, there's a laptop. Oh, if you haven't bought this raffle ticket, some are only buying £5. Give yourself an opportunity to really win something. This, you may know somebody that you know you needed to give a laptop to, you never know. You can give it to them for a tenner. Oh please, for the photograph, man. Thank you. Put our hands together as we welcome the chairman of the organizing committee, who's going to take us through the American auction, Mr. Babatunde Falode. Let's put our hands together for this man. He's worked so hard. Let's keep clapping as he comes. You're very welcome, sir.
Thank you very much. Good evening, everyone. This part of my event is what I love the most. It's about raising money. We've got a massive TV there. The rules to get an American auction. Anybody wants to go about here? Okay. This is the way we're going to play this. Someone will start the bid. We'll bid in multiples of five, so £5. I'll give an example. So I go, for example, £10. Now, if I don't get any bidder, then I will win it for £10. Otherwise, we go £15, but you pay the delta, so you pay the difference. So £10, if you bid for £10, you put £10 down, and then you pray to God that no one else bids, and then you win it. It's happened before, it happened. So, can we start this? I want to do this within 10 minutes, if it's possible. So are we ready? Are we ready? And of course, if we're ready, then I need a fourth bidder. Fourth bidder. Fourth bidder. Fourth bidder. £10. Where? £10. £10. £10. No, multiples of five. £10. Get my collectors, please. Ladu. £10. £10. £10. £10. Collect £10. £10. £10. Going once. Going once. 10. 10. 10. 15 mil. Go with me as well. 800.
This is like so energizing. But first of all, can I ask us to appreciate our two wonderful helpers? Please give them a round of applause. And to present this gift, may I call on Mrs. Juliet Benson, please, one of our trustees.
Yes, sir. They've been told to take this.
Mrs. Juliet Benson?
Paid for it now. So maybe you.
Folk song. Shake, I want to hear about Abiba, I want to hear about Abiba. There's a song. Be old Bob Moe, yeah. Be old Bob Moe, yeah. So I fed the doctor.
Chairman, immediately pass Kanu Chairman to pitch the first draw. A round of applause for Mr. Babatunde Olori. A round of applause for Mr. Babatunde Olori. Pitch the first draw, please. What's the number, sir?
329.
329, 329, what other is this? Thank you. Can I call on the chairman, board of trustees, to do this last presentation? To pick up the winning, the grand ticket, and then do the presentation. A round of applause for the chairman.
To the end of yet another wonderful collection of celebrations for you today on the city that is set upon the hill that cannot be hidden event. Before I go, I'd like to encourage you to make plans to celebrate even at the end of this COVID-19. As many of you as want to have a Thanksgiving party, even a Thanksgiving service and celebration, call us. We'll be there to celebrate with you. By the grace of Almighty God, every one of us shall be post-COVID-19 survivors. See you same time next week. Bye for now.